I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. Some dude with a screwdriver trying
something.
Yeah, and then you have like people with fake guns in their trunk shooting like BBs and nonstop.
There's always some action.
Is it easier to drive this one on the road than like a freeway, not off than a Defender? Or is it the same?
This is easier because it's automatic.
Yeah.
As opposed to the stick shift.
Land Rover.
This has more comforts. You got better AC, better amenities. Yeah, more comfortable, right?
Do you run at all now? Do you do any drills?
I haven't done anything right now. Not this month. Like I said, I'll start next month in September. At least a few days, you know, because I'm going to be busy, you know, doing a lot of different travel, but I'll get a few days in the gym. I'll get a few days.
Mikey, what's your favorite Fernando Vargas moment?
Favorite Fernando Vargas moment?
Yeah, in the ring, out of the ring, in life.
I remember him. He fought Ross Thompson and he spit on his face. See, we were at the press conference.
Yeah.
And Ross Thompson walks up to the stage behind Vargas and slaps Vargas in the head like that.
Yeah. Disrespectful.
And he gets up and he fucking socks him and follows him on stage and they made a big thing. So then Fernando tells him, when I fucking knock you out, I'm fucking spit on your face. Disrespecting me like that.
Yeah.
Spit on your face. And when he does drop him, he goes up to him and fucking spits on him.
Did he get disqualified for it?
He just got fined, I think.
It's hard to spit with the mouthpiece, no?
He did it. He dropped him like two times. But the first time he went, the referee was still too close.
Yeah.
He pushed him away and he didn't get a chance to do it. But on the second time, he fucking goes and fucking spits at him.
That's
tight.
Fighters don't do this. No Fernando Vargas's anymore.
No, things have changed. Things have changed.
He has a lot of respect towards your dad.
Yes.
Of course, Robert, yourself.
Yes.
Do you remember him as a kid at all, or were you not born yet? When he was with you guys?
I remember him staying at the house.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
I was a little kid. I was young. I don't know, I was probably
like 3, 4.
Like 4 years old or something, 5 years old, but I remember him staying at the house sometime with my brother Robert. I remember going to the gym a lot in my dad's little Ford Ranger. We'd actually ride in the back camper, in the bed of the truck. We'd ride in that because it was only a two-seater truck. And my dad's was a stick shift, so it was Robert, Fernando, me, and I mean whoever else. I mean,
Roger,
yeah, stuff like that. So we'd go in the back of the bed.
Was it kind of funny?
The top.
It's safe if it's a camper. In Dallas, it's legal, by the way.
Yes.
I'm out of California.
Imagine riding right now and we have the kids in the back.
Nah, not in this day and age.
I'd go straight to jail.
Yeah, probably.
You say yeah.
Mike, if there's one thing you think people underestimate you in boxing, what is it?
They underestimate my skills just in general.
Why?
Just the outside, you're just watching from the outside. You're not gonna see anything out of this world. You're not gonna see fancy footwork. You're not gonna see the flashiest hands. You're not gonna see the quickest reflexes or anything like that, you know? Or that aggressive style. You're not gonna see nothing that stands out that impresses anybody. So, from the outside, I think it's not a big deal. It's a stand up, straight up, 1-2 kind of guy. Nothing special, nothing fancy, nothing great. So they underestimate me.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.